In this presentation, I would like to explain you about the IDE Barcelona, which is the spatial data infrastructure for the region of Barcelona. Also, I would like to talk about how we do cooperate in order to develop a smart region infrastructure. The presentation includes 6 points. First, we'll see what is a spatial data infrastructure and how they arise. Then, the need for interoperability and the use of standards. After that, I will examine the content of the European Inspire Directive and its relation with SDIs, and which is the state of the spatial data infrastructure at Diputació of Barcelona and its technological platform called SIDMUN. For last, I will talk a little bit about the relation between IDE Barcelona and smart initiatives. And finally, some conclusions and time for questions. Okay, so let's start with the first point. As you know, throughout the history, several infrastructures have changed citizens' life and the society. For example, the railways, the telegraph, the road network, have had a very important impact on society. And we say that in this 21st century, there is a new infrastructure that is also changing how public administration processes information. And also it's changing the citizens' life. It is called the spatial data infrastructure. It's commonly known by the acronym of SDI, and it's about geographic information. As you can see in this graph, the growth of this infrastructure is following the same that had the railway in that moment. So it's quite an important infrastructure. But how they arise? As you know, municipal management and government, municipal management and planning applications always need maps and cartography. And every time they need more and more maps and geographic information. But these maps sometimes are located at the municipality itself, but some other times they are located at other institutions, like at the Diputació, at Generalitat of Catalonia, at the Cartographic Institute, and others. So these applications and programs must know where the maps are located and how to go to collect them automatically. It happens the same with the regional management applications. At Diputació, our users need maps, and these maps sometimes are outside Diputació. They are located at Cartographic Institute or Generalitat or any other organization. So also, the programs must collect the maps from the servers they are located. And it's the same with other professional applications, like the ones used by architects and by engineers. So, what happens? It happens that geographic information is traveling every time from server to server automatically without any user interaction. And when this happens, we are talking about interoperability. Interoperability is when different systems exchange information, exchange and interpret data without the user's interaction. But how all these devices and systems can talk each other? It's only possible if they speak the same language, and they speak the same language if they use standards. So standard, using standards is very important. But when we talk about geographic data, we must talk also about the Open Geospatial Consortium, known by the acronym of OGC. It's the consortium that defines standards for geographic information. They define several standards, but the most important ones for us are the visualization services and also the catalog services. Visualization services permit the user to visualize the map on the device. And metadata catalog services helps the programs to automatically find which data is available, where is it located, and how they can collect that data automatically. Okay, now we have standards, we have interoperability, we have geographic information, but who organizes all these elements in order to have a useful system? In fact, it's the European Union through the INSPIRE directive who organizes all these elements. They think that geographic information is crucial for government management and planning, and also for the environment. Also, they think that cross-border management with geographic information is essential. They say that, for example, if there is a contamination problem in a river in any European country, all the countries where this contaminated water is flowing also have the same problem. So it's essential for one government to be able to visualize the geographic information of the neighboring governments. So the European Union says that it must be a European infrastructure of spatial data throughout Europe. And this European infrastructure must be formed by each SDIs located at national level. And each national SDI must be composed by the regional ones, and each regional one must be composed by the local SDI. So in 2007, the European Parliament approved the INSPIRE directive, which was transposed in Spain by the LISIGE law. And in Catalan, we have the Catalonian Cartographic Plan. The INSPIRE directive must be fully compliant for 2020 at all member states. And what does this directive define? First of all, it defines which data sets or which group of types of information are affected by this legislation. There are 34 data sets included in this directive. So every public administration that produces any of these 34 data sets has to comply with INSPIRE. Some examples of data sets are addresses, which is a municipal competence. So every municipality in Catalonia and in Spain has to comply with the INSPIRE referring to addresses. Other examples are transport network, land use, utilities, services, protected sites, and so on. What else? INSPIRE also defines that we must have a catalog service to be able to find which data is available throughout Europe and also which services are available to collect this data. Then we have also to have available a visualization service for each data set, and also a downloading service for each data set. All these services are based on the OGC standards, so they are also standards. Visualization services and downloading services form what is known by open geodata. Open geodata is an open data portal, but when talking about geographic information. So every public administration that produces any of these data sets has to have an open data portal for geographic information, but it must be Inspire compliant. It can be, it's not enough with any open data portal. Okay, and now, what is the state of the SDI at Diputació of Barcelona and in our region? As you know, our region includes 311 municipalities, and about more or less 80% of them have less than 20,000 inhabitants. So, as you can imagine, the smallest ones and also the medium-sized ones require our support in developing their SDI. In order to be able to perform their government management and planning, but also to fulfill the legislation. So this is what we do in our department. And we have created a regional spatial data infrastructure, which includes information from our organization, but also from all these municipalities. And it's called IDE Barcelona. And also, we implemented a local geoportal of for its SDI for each municipality. And the name is IDE Local and the name of the municipality. But all this process wouldn't be able without the cooperation. We are cooperating within other departments in Diputació of Barcelona, but also we are cooperating with the municipalities. This is the website of the IDE Barcelona, the regional SDI. And here you can see the elements required by the Inspire directive. And this is an example of a local SDI of one of the municipality of Cardedeu. And also, you can see that they all have the Inspire elements. But how do we implement all this infrastructure? We use a technological platform called SITMUN. In SITMUN is where we collect data or information from councils, from Diputació, and from other organizations. Sometimes we load this data into the platform. Some other times we just store the link to the standard visualization service. And with several back office tools, we generate each element in the SDI, like a GIS tool, like metadata catalog, and several processes which are used by the municipalities. Now, which is the origin of this SITMUN platform? In 2003, we started the SITMUN project within an initiative Interreg SUDOE program with seven main partners from Spain and Portugal. Our main goal was to create a geographic information system as a global service for all small and medium-sized municipalities. In fact, in that moment, we didn't know that we were creating a cloud service for the municipalities. Now we know that it is a cloud, but at that moment, nobody was talking about cloud computing. In 2005, the SITMUN project finished, having achieved its goal, And we created a local network and a European network. The local network is composed by clients of this service. Nowadays, we have 280 local governments connected to this network, to this platform, with more than 1,300 users. So we take profit of the economy of scale. We created the European network composed by providers of this service. Nowadays, we are 10 partners from Spain and Portugal, and within us, we reuse and share software and also best practices. So we cooperate between supra-municipal governments to achieve efficiency. Nowadays, the Simon project continues evolving according to technical and also to legal requirements. On the map, on the left side, you can see where the European network members are located. Here in Catalonia, you can see that three of the four regions of Catalonia are covered by this platform. And you can find more information about this open European network at simon.org. And all administrations in Europe are invited to participate in it. On the right side, you can see the local network in the case of the region of Barcelona. And you can see all the municipalities connected to this platform. And you can access the platform at simon.diva.cat. Now, which are the benefits of the Simon platform? Well, it permits to have continuous geographic data, which is essential for government management and planning. It is continuous, so every entity or every government can visualize information of the neighboring governments. It's a foundation to easily implement SDIs according to the applicable law, and it helps to comply with one of the most important INSPIRE principles, which is that data should be collected only once, and it should be kept where it can be maintained most effectively. So this is the case of addresses that the data set. In Catalonia, addresses data set is a municipal competence. So all municipalities can maintain their addresses just connecting to this platform. Now I will show you just four examples of what users can do with this platform. Here you can see that the user can intersect the cadastral parcels with the addresses. So it's very easy to just visualizing the map to find which buildings still don't have any address in the system. In this example, the user can find which classified activities are located within an industrial area. They can see them on the map, and also they can export the grid. This is an example of how users can download the geographic data in different formats and in different coordinate systems. And the last example, you can see that the platform is available for mobile devices. In this case, users in the municipality, but also citizens, can report any public space issue that they found. So in this case, we say that the citizen acts as a sensor. And the last point, the relation, we have seen the relation between the IDE Barcelona SDI and the Simon platform. Now we will see a relation with the smart initiatives. It is clear that smart initiatives require up-to-date and reliable spatial data. Without good information, technology is not useful. So we think that a smart government is or should be a smart, a spatially connected government. And from this point of view, we think that IDE Barcelona and Simun is a foundation for any smart territory initiative. Remember the graph in the beginning of the presentation? We had the local government exchanging geographic information with other government levels and other organizations. But when we add a third stakeholder, which is the citizens, and is the most important one, and the sensors, then we can talk about a smart town. Always geographic information is being exchanged between all the stakeholders. But what is a smart territory? We think that it is the result of the cooperation between smart towns and different government levels, plus one shared goal, which is to make a territory better, stronger, and smarter. We think the secret to regional development is cooperation. And from this point of view, we think IDE Barcelona is ready to cooperate with any smart initiative. Like, for example, the Smart Cat initiative, which is included in the National Pact to a Digital Society in Catalonia. And remember that Simun platform is installed at Girona, Lleida, and Barcelona Catalan regions, three of the four regions. So all these three regions have already a spatial data infrastructure. And just to summarize the presentation, remember that there is a new infrastructure that is changing public administration processes and citizens' life. It is the spatial data infrastructure known by SDI. It is regulated by the European Union through the Inspire Directive and by using standards. And as you have seen during the presentation, IDE Barcelona and IDE Locals are the SDIs for the region of Barcelona and also for its municipalities. IDE Barcelona is a foundation for any smart territory initiative and is based on the Simun platform. And remember that the main principle of IDE Barcelona and Simun is cooperation. Thank you very much for your attention.